In the second part of the text tutorial, I will show you some of the advanced features, such as how to scroll text, add fades, insert effects, and add start and end credits. Firstly, I will show you a video I created using these text features to give you an idea of how these look when implemented. This is just some video footage I took when on holidays in Seville. Here you can see I've added two lines of scrolling text. I've also rotated two scrolling lines of text, which are intersecting. I've added effects to a piece of text. Added a background color to a text segment and moved it to the bottom of the screen. And at the end, I've added a vertical scrolling text for my end credits. So let me show you how I created this. First of all, I've already added and crossfaded my video, and now I want to add my text. I simply right-click on the mixing screen and select Insert Video Credits. The Video Credits dialog box will appear, and I'll insert my text. I'll highlight my text and change the font and size of it. I can also change the color of the whole text or individual pieces. I can now see the text in the video output screen. However, I would like this text to scroll horizontally onto the screen. Firstly, I'll select the Scroll Horizontal button in the dialog box. I'll now place my cursor at the beginning of the text and insert tabs by pressing the Tab button on my keyboard. As you insert tabs, the text will begin to move out of the text placement window and a scroll bar will appear at the bottom of the window. I'll now grab the play bar in the mixing screen to see the scrolling taking place. I can see my text ends abruptly at the end of the segment, so I need to add some tabs to the end of my text. Again, the play bar is very useful as you can use it to display how the text will look in the video output screen. I can also control the speed at which the scroll happens by adjusting the length of the text segment. The smaller the text segment, the quicker the scroll, and the longer the segment, the slower the scroll. So now that I'm happy with my first piece of scrolling text at the top, I want to place a similar piece of text to the bottom. This is a very simple process. I simply select the first segment, right-click, and select Copy Segment. I can then paste it underneath. In the new segment, I can click on the text properties icon to access the credits dialog box. Because of the inserted tabs, you can use the scroll bar to access the text and make any changes to it. To position the text, I simply move the vertical margin sliders to position the text to the bottom of the screen. Again, I can use the play bar to see how it looks in the video output screen. So now I will show you how I rotated the text and intersected them. Again, I created a text segment and scrolled my text as shown previously. I simply moved the vertical margin slider to the middle of the placement window. I then copied and pasted this segment underneath, like before. To rotate the text segment, click on the segment properties icon for that segment. I then simply use the rotate pot to position my text to my desired location. I can use the play bar in the segment properties to view your text. I'll do the same for the other segment. Again, I can use the play bar at any time to visually see my text in the output screen. I will also introduce some fades at the beginning and end of my segments. Now I'll move on and show you how to insert effects onto a text segment. Again, I've just created a text segment with the text Champions of Europe inserted and moved the vertical slider to position the text in the middle. To insert an effect onto the text segment, simply right-click on it and select Video Effects. From the drop-down menu, I will select Rotate. The blue effects grid can be adjusted in length and the envelope can be altered to manipulate the effect. Double-click on the envelope to insert a node, which can then be moved to adjust the envelope. I can also access and change the properties of the effect by clicking on the effects properties icon on the effects grid. I also want to add a second effect. I will minimize the rotate effect by clicking on the minimize expand button and then right click and select zoom from the video effects drop down menu. Again, this effect can be adjusted and altered by using the envelope and properties. I will also add fades to the beginning and end of the text segment. Now I will show you how to put a color bar at the bottom of the video output screen, with text scrolling across the screen. Again, I have set up a text segment with tabs inserted and the text scrolling button activated. I will turn off the transparent background button and change the background color to Fire Engine Red. I'll now click on the segment properties icon on my text segment. When I position my mouse over the video display window, a hand grab icon will appear. By clicking and holding the left mouse button, I can adjust the entire frame and position it to any area in the screen. In this case, I will position the frame at the bottom of the screen. Again, I can use the play bar to see how it displays in the video output screen. You can also use the vertical and horizontal offset sliders for exact positioning. And I'll click close. Again, I'll introduce fades to the start and end of my segment. The last feature I'll show you is how to vertically scroll text, which is a very nice feature when making start and end credits. Here I've simply typed in the text that I would like to appear at the end of my video, and the text is aligned to center. To get the text to vertically scroll, position your cursor at the beginning of the text. I then simply insert returns at the start, and you'll notice the text will begin to move down the text placement window. The play bar is very useful here in displaying how the text will scroll. You'll notice the text will end abruptly after the last piece of text, so I'll position my cursor after the last character of my text, and again insert returns. Using the My Play bar, I can preview my text. Again, you can adjust the speed of the scroll by adjusting the length of the text segment. If you would like the text to scroll in the opposite direction, simply click on the segment properties icon and select the reverse play button. So by using these news features, I've created a nice video which I can now upload to YouTube or other video sharing sites, or simply share it with family and friends.